Thank you so much for joining us tonight at 11 o'clock. I'm Elise Chingeri. Tonight, we continue to follow that deadly crash that happened last night on Pine Island Road in Matlacha, where a man hit multiple people, vehicles, and a building, killing an 80-year-old woman and injuring multiple others. Right now, we know that Florida Highway Patrol says a 24-year-old man, a Cape Coral man, was behind the wheel of that white car that you've seen in these videos that was involved and that charges are pending. As we continue to push for more answers in this investigation, tonight our NBC2's Sarah Mankiewicz sat down with the owner of that barbecue restaurant that this happened outside of. And Sarah, the owner, saw the aftermath of that crash and tells you he lost a friend yesterday.
Yeah, Elise, he did. I mean, the crash happened right here at that barbecue place, and the owner exclusively tells me that he was sitting right here with those people that were hit by the car just moments before the crash.
I had literally just made a cup of coffee, took a sip, sat it down, and some people walked in, and I walked in to greet them. And then it was probably about 30 to 60 seconds later.
John Petrus owns that barbecue place and says the people injured in the crash, along with the woman killed, were close friends who would stop by all the time.
They very much were like family. But Butch and Mary Lou is like family to everybody on this island. If this island had grandparents or parents, that would be Butch and Mary Lou.
A night of friends having a good time quickly turned into a nightmare.
I can't even describe it. It was just carnage. It was hundreds of feet of debris and injuries and dear friends of mine, too. It's hard to go from reality to surreal that fast.
Steve Buchner says the same car crashed into his truck.
Slammed into my truck because I wasn't able to get out of the way at the time. I just kind of like a deer in the headlights.
FHP confirms an 80-year-old woman was killed and four others injured, three taken by ambulance and another airlifted. Petrus tells me he's been in touch with two of the people who were injured.
Well, Tom broke his back in five places, five broken bones in his back. They'll release him, he told me today, when he can walk, but he can't get off the bed.
Petrus tells me another victim he knows, who he calls Butch, just had surgery for his leg, several broken ribs, and a cut on his head.
Oh, the emotions are floodgates. Couldn't sleep last night. The loss of Mary Lou will be felt forever.
As for the tables out front, Petrus says there will never be one out there again.
That won't be happening here anymore, no more.
Wait, you're telling me no more tables out front, Kevin?
No more tables out front.
We're still working to confirm the names of the victims with officials and the driver as well. And of course, you can count on us to keep you updated with those answers when we learn more. For now, I'm live and local along Pine Island Road on Matlacha, Sarah Mankiewicz, NBC2.
Sarah, thank you so much. And tonight we also have team coverage on this story as the loss is affecting our community and still has people pretty shaken up over what they saw there last night. Our NBC2's Mohammed Abdulkhal, we spoke with more people about this there along Pine Island Road.
People here in Matlacha are lost for words after last night's fatal crash that happened outside this restaurant. They tell me the community needs to stay together during tough times like this.
It is heavy today. It's a very heavy, quiet feeling on the island.
The Saturday evening turned into a nightmare in a matter of seconds. As Florida Highway Patrol confirms, a 24-year-old man from Cape Coral struck five victims who were sitting outside the barbecue place along Pine Island Road. Three of the victims were rushed to the hospital by ambulance, another flown by helicopter, and an 80-year-old woman was pronounced deceased on scene. Jessica Norman's heart is heavy after hearing the tragedy, telling me she knows the woman who was killed.
Mary Lou was the first person that I met when I came here. She is a dynamic of a woman, just turned 80, just had her birthday.
This morning, around 8:40, we saw people coming together to clean up the debris left behind. Others also paid their respects by leaving flowers here.
Really resilient. They're very resilient people, and they all band together in a way that you don't see in bigger cities. This is almost like a country feel.
Residents like the Hartmans are also heartbroken, wondering how this even happened. Also saying last night's scene is something they will have to think about for the rest of their lives. Now making them second guess about dining outside.
To us, that's very, very sad. And makes us think twice about sitting on roadside cafes.
There is going to be a lot of unity and a lot of bonding here on the island through this because that's what the people do on the island here.
Reporting in Matlacha, Mohammed Abdulkhalwi, NBC2.